Hey, what's up? You're listening to the Petty by Nature podcast featuring the pettiest host on this side of the Mississippi River, the one and only Miss Keyona Spade, and the pink hair diva herself, Miss Stacie Stiletto. So fasten your seatbelts and enjoy this petty ride.
Hey, you guys, and just a reminder, don't forget to go and find us, like us, and share us on our social media pages. You can find us at PBN Podcast on Facebook and Snapchat, and on IG and Twitter, you can find us at Petty by Nature too.
Okay, so this is our introduction episode, of course. So we will be talking about our first date experience. You know, we think it's fitting, seeing how this is the first episode. We will be doing a question and answer session. We will definitely be talking about sex on the first date do's and don'ts, and the first date edition of Ballin' on a Budget.
So, the first question we would want to answer would be, where are we from? So, Miss Stacie Stiletto, pink hair diva, where are you from?
I'm originally from Cali, from Compton, if you want to be specific. I moved to the Atlanta area in 2007 when I was chasing behind a man. That's how I ended up here. What about you, honey? Where are you from?
Originally, I'm from New York, born and raised, and then was kind of snatched up out of New York and moved down to Georgia because my mama was running behind some man. So I ain't had no choice, and now I'm here, and I've been here ever since.
Lord, it's always a man.
It's always a man. It is. You learn. You live and you learn.
Okay, the next question that we got is, are you single? I am currently in an intense love affair with myself and my side hustles. So, I don't know what to tell you.
I mean, but that's technically, you're not single.
Yeah, you know, it'd be like that. You know, everyone, because I got the whole Stacie thing. You know, this podcast is our new baby, so we have to take the time to properly nurture and watch this grow. Then I have the petty tease. So, you know, I'm out here trying to get it. So right now, this is what I'm focused on.
Well, so for me to answer that question, no, I'm not single. I'm in a couple of relationships. I am in a relationship, I got bae, and then I have a relationship with PayPal, and I have a relationship with school, and things of that nature. So no, I'm not single.
Matter of fact, shout out to bae, shout out to PayPal. You know, if y'all trying to bless us, you can definitely hit our PayPal, pettybynature2@gmail.com. We are accepting all donations. We are accepting all funds, credit. Matter of fact, credit, debit. We accept food stamps. I accept hair. On occasion, we accept food. No, fuck with us.
I mean, hey, it's a community thing.
Yes, PayPal is definitely community-based.
Right.
Okay, the next question that we got is, if you had to pick a song to represent you, what song would it be?
Oh, my goodness. You know it's really not one. But if I'm going to pick one, and as of right now in my life, it would have to be Cardi B, Forever. And that's because if a bitch beef with me, we going to be forever. I'm just petty like that.
You know what? That's gonna have to be the show theme song. I'm with you on that. I can dig it. Ran down on that bitch twice. Ran down on that bitch twice. You know me, I be with whatever. If a bitch be for me, we gon' be forever. Ran down on that bitch twice. Rain down on that bitch twice. You know me, I be with whatever. If a bitch be for me, we gon' be forever. My song, if I had my theme song, my motto for life, I'm gonna have to take it back. It's that K. Michelle, Love 'Em All. Have you heard it?
I have, yes, I have.
That's my shit. They think I love them, but I love them all. I need another one to get over the other one. Come on, man. That's my shit.
I could dig that.
So if you out there and you supposed to be my bae, my bad, bro.
Y'all don't
dry snitching on myself.
It don't worry. She ain't shit, and I'm sure she done told you she wasn't shit, so you know by now. You ain't surprised by this comment, so don't even get into your feelings.
At all, get out your feelings, baby.
Right.
Baby, you know you're the only one for me. You know I was just playing. This is all talk, just for radio. Babe, you my one and only.
That's what she said.
Okay, moving on. Our first topic of discussion is our first date experience. So, Keyona, tell us about your first date ever in life.
Of course I gotta go first. But my first date experience would have to be a kind of like a null and void, because I didn't really have a first date. Like a typical first date kind of thing. You know, not like asked out on a date and, you know, dressed up all cute and stuff like that and went out, like, you know, on that kind of tip. However, I mean, I've gone out. I've experienced going out and being cute, dressed up, being cute. You know, matter of fact, last year on my birthday. But yeah, I don't have like an extensive, intense ass first date experience, because I was real hot in the ass and I wasn't being asked on dates back then. So yeah, that's pretty much my first date experience. Yeah.
Okay, well, my first date, well, okay, let me give y'all a backstory. I technically, I can never say that shit. Wasn't allowed to date until I was 16, but I remember being in middle school in 7th and 8th grade, and me and my homegirls would get together on the weekends and have my mom drop us off at the skating rink, but we didn't already told little buddy, hey, Friday night, meet us at Lambert at 7:30. So I was doing that for a long while. Or Saturday night, meet us at the $1.50 movie. But my first official date wasn't until my 2-3 weeks after my 16th birthday. And I'm not going to say his name, but he was definitely bae. He was bae for a long, if y'all know me in real life, y'all already know who the hell I'm talking about. But yeah, my first official legal date, I was 16. And I got dressed, got all kid and shit. And he came to pick me up in his car. And we went to the movies. We went to go see what movie was out back then? I think it was the third Matrix. Then we went to Olive Garden, and then he tried to get me to park somewhere so we can do a couple things, but I wasn't about that life back then, so that date was over quick. But he was still bae. We still, you know, ended up dating and going out and shit.
So at this age, where little buddy was getting cars and money for Olive Garden?
Bitch, Olive Garden not expensive. And I had a car too. I got my car on my 16th birthday.
Oh yeah, okay. See, I ain't never experienced that, you know. Hasa diddy.
So speaking of first dates, we're gonna go to social media. And we gonna ask social media, sex on the first date, is you fucking or nah? Back then, it was definitely a nah for me, but, you know, I was underage. I was only 16. I wasn't trying to do all of that. So we want to hear from y'all. Is y'all fucking or nah?
Oh, goodness gracious. Well, I know that on my social media, asking this question, it actually was very funny to see the responses. And most of my responses came from guys. And I'm not really surprised about that. And the majority of them were pretty much like, you know, if the date went well and we like vibing or whatever, then yeah, it's all good. Like, we can go ahead and do this. Like, if they felt that connection. I did have somebody say no, that they wasn't about that because they wanted to kind of see if something would go longer and see what kind of female she was if it didn't happen. But for the majority, I would say at least 90% of the answers that they gave were, I mean, yeah, we hooking up because if this vibing and we made it all the way to the end of the night, I don't see why not. So, yeah. What about on your social media?
Yeah, social media link shit. Majority of the people on my friends list, they fucking on the first night. And well, let me find it.
So basically, everybody that fuck with Stacie ain't shit.
Yeah, they ain't shit. At all. Everybody fucking. It wasn't no ifs, ands, or buts about it. And then the question that I got asked back, what you mean? Not fucking on the first date. What is that?
Ah. I'm gonna need everybody on your page to get their life together.
No, so then I had to ask, okay, so because everybody was fucking, they was looking at me like I'm crazy, like, come on now, you know what's up. So then I asked, do you think less of a woman if she fucks on the first date? And this is where shit got tricky. Because I got 47 comments here, and one guy says, not if she has more to offer. So if she has more to offer, then he does not think less of her. But if that's all she got to offer and she fucking on the first date, he's going to think less of her. A friend of mine, Ron, said, how could I? That means I have to think less of me, because for her to do it on the first date, she had to do it with me. Think about it. To be real, if I liked her, you know, no, I'm not going to think less of her. But if you want just sex, then that's just not an excuse to see her.
My question would be, though, it would be to the first response you just gave, that one of the followers said she had more to offer. But the thing about it is, if it's the first date, how you know she got more to offer and you going to get past that anyway to decide whether you gonna fuck or not? So I'm just wondering, if you only known them and you going out on that first date, how you know she got more to offer?
Exactly. And then
that would just be my thought.
Petty Guerrero says, no, if she wants to have sex on a first date, then she can't say shit about me when I come in 36 seconds. Really, bruh? That's what you got for my life?
No, I can still say something about you coming in 36 seconds. Yes, the fuck I can. Because especially if we fucking on the first date, I'm sorry, sir. You're going to have to be coming better than that on the first day, at least.
Yeah, I can't get jiggy with that. And then Jay said that he will respect her more for being grown about it. If we both on the same vibe, great. If not, no pressure. But I find it childish to want it and deny oneself due to societal norms.
I mean, I agree with that statement. I think that women in today's society get a bad rep when they want to have sex and they're considered to be hoes, and just because that they're comfortable in their sexuality and are like, yo, this is what I want to do. But society makes them look like they're some hoe or something just because they know what they want. And that's where the issue come in at. Because I'm just saying, like, if old boy could go and fuck and he could decide that he want to fuck, hey, I should be able to say that I know what I want to do when I want to do it. And if I want to fuck, it shouldn't make me a hoe.
So, does that mean you're fucking on the first date?
Child, let me explain something to you. Yeah, I've been fucking since I was 16 years old. And if I want to fuck, I'm going to fuck. That's pretty much the bottom line to that. If I want you, we digging each other, and we on that level, yeah, I'm fucking. That's it.
That's what's up. I'm not going to say I'm necessarily fucking on the first date, but I'm definitely going to let you give me some head. That can definitely happen. I've gone...
Because you ain't...
I know it. And it's like, okay, this is what happened. Out on a date, you know, we kicking it, we vibing, we chilling or whatever, and next thing I know, my panties are down around my ankles, and he is sucking the soul out of my body. I don't know what the fuck happened. And I'm just sitting here having this wonderful experience. I'm like, yeah, I can't let this man just do me like this any kind of way. So then I pretend like my phone's ringing and I check my phone. Like, oh shit, my sister in trouble. I gotta go get my sister. And I got the hell up out of there.
You ain't shit from like the 5th level.
And I've done that a couple of times. So if you listening and I've done that to you, my bad, Sheldon. I got you though. I got you. I'm gonna send you a I'm gonna send you a gift card.
Yeah, but she don't.
I'm gonna send you a gift card. Okay?
To the Applebee's, and you gonna afford 2 for $20. She not even gonna give you enough to go to Red Lobster. Fuck the Beyonce. If you fuck me good, I treat your ass to Red Lobster. Nah, you going straight to Applebee's, my nigga. $2 for $20.
Would have to mean that we had to fuck for me to take this nigga to Red Lobster. What you mean?
True. Either way, if you getting a meal, I mean, ain't no
I
wrong
mean, I
with
done
food.
Fed him once. Why I gotta feed him again, though? Why I gotta be Applebee's? Why can't I just give him an iTunes gift card?
I mean, because, ooh, that's coming out of pocket.
Oh, no, shit, bitch. $10.
That's $10. Even better.
Boom, we good.
Oh, see? You can't even get a drink out that. You could get a couple songs, and that's it. You can't do anything else with that. You could get 2 songs, that's the end of that.
Okay, now we have a couple social media shout outs. Not many. We just got 2 this week. The first shout out that I want to give is definitely to Petty Emoji. Petty Emoji has been rocking with us since we jumped off the porch. They are always showing us love, supporting our petty endeavors. Let me tell y'all something. Because usually when you run across the business or somebody else who's doing the same thing that you're doing, usually there's some kind of animosity, some kind of beef. But since day one, Petty Emoji, who are selling Petty t-shirts, they have been super supportive of us. They're always sharing our shit on social media. They're always liking our shit. They're telling their people to come and fuck with us. They are definitely the real MVP. And you can check out Petty Emoji on Twitter at Petty Emoji 1, the number 1. You can check out Petty Emoji on IG under the name Petty Emoji and visit their website and definitely cop a Petty tee. Their website address is pettyemoji.myshopify.com. Again, their website is pettyemoji.myshopify.com. Okay, now here's my baby. Now, you know we got a shout out, Excuse My Petty. If y'all don't know it, Excuse My Petty sells petty tees. And this ain't your typical mom and pop t-shirt shop. If you ain't shit like us, and I'm pretty sure you are because you fucking with this podcast, then you definitely need to check out these tees. My favorite tee on the site right now is the I'm Faithful But I Thought A Little tee. Yes, bitch, you heard me. I'm Faithful But I Thought A Little. Don't act like I'm the only one, bitch. You can definitely check out Excuse My Petty on Facebook, IG, and Twitter under the name Excuse My Petty 26 and visit the website www.excusemypetty.com.
Yes. I'm definitely getting me a shirt because there's a couple of things on Excuse My Petty that I want to get, especially for the summer, because I just want to have a whole bunch of shit throw on a shirt that say some shit like that I'm faithful and I thought a little. So definitely seek out Excuse My Petty. So if you want to be a guest and you're interested, we want you to come and be petty with us. And you can send your emails to pettybynature2@gmail.com. Again, it's pettybynature2@gmail.com, and put guest as the subject headline, and we will get back to you and we will let you know, and we will discuss topics and get you on a show. And also, if you need petty advice dealing with relationship issues, drama at work, you know, that bitch named Keisha that keeps sitting at your cubicle, you and your bestie not seeing eye to eye, then you go ahead and shoot us another email and we'll review your situation on the show, and then we'll offer our petty opinion on how we would handle the situation. And that's just how we would. So don't think that we telling y'all to go off on somebody and you send your email to us and you telling us about what happened with you and Bae, and we like, oh well, why that nigga sleep dirt bleach in his Xbox? Disclaimer. Bitch, don't do that.
Disclaimer.
Cause then it's gonna be on us. These are just
suggestions on what we would do.
So
use these suggestions at your own risk. We cannot be held responsible nor liable if you decide to go out in these streets and fuck up your life. These are just jokes, people.
Exactly. So with that being said, let us hear your petty situations and give you petty advice, and you go ahead and send your emails to pettybynature2@gmail.com and put petty advice in the subject line.
And again, and we will definitely follow get us petty on all social with media. You on the you can show. Follow us on Facebook and Snapchat under PBN Podcast. You can follow us on IG and Twitter under pettybynature2.
All right, you guys, we're going to move right along to our first date's do's and don'ts. Number one on my list for the first date dudes is find out what your date is interested in and build your date around that. Women aren't expecting you to pay an arm and a leg to take them on a date. What they are expecting you to do is put forth some effort. I can't tell you the number of dinner and movie dates that I've been on. I can't even remember the guys' names I went on the damn dates with. And if it was you, bruh, and you listening, my bad, Sheldon. You know what I can tell you, though? I remember Ryan taking me to the park and having a water gun fight with the other couples. I remember Malcolm hanging a sheet on the side of his house and playing movies on a projector that he rented from the local library and watching movies on his trampoline. I even remember that Steve took me to an open mic poetry night at the coffee house and signed us up to perform. And I didn't know we were performing until they called our names. Talk about being awkward. I remember Dee getting a few canvases from Walmart, some paint and craft supplies, and we created portraits of one another. That had to have been one of my most memorable dates, because anybody who know me for real know I'm big into arts and crafts. I love glitter and glue and Mod Podge, and I'm really artsy, and that's my shit. He handcrafted that date specifically for me. Find out what your date is interested in and create memories with her. You want to be Mike who took a salsa class with me instead of what's-his-face who took me out once. Or was that other guy? Anywho, moving right along. The next on my list is be yourself. You don't have to lie to kick it. That one should basically be self-explanatory. The next on the list is let your date know the dress code so they can dress appropriately. I'm not going to go into too much detail about this, but back in the day, this guy took me out and he picked me up at the house, and I had on this little black dress. Ladies, you know which little black dress I'm talking about. The one that hugs your curves just right, your boobies are sitting up all perky, and your ass is just looking like, damn, Gina. Do y'all know this motherfucker took me to church? Yeah, I wasn't with it. If you're gonna take your girl out somewhere, please let her know the dress code. The next on the list is make sure you have the funds to cover your portion of the date and possibly an Uber home. Don't let them get you out in the streets and you slipping. And the last on my list of do's is get a box of condoms. Apparently all y'all is out here fucking on the first date. There should be no reason why y'all is out in these streets with no condoms. Safety first, okay?
Don't judge us, bitch. Don't judge us. It's not that serious. But nah, truth be told, yeah, we should have condoms. But I get it. Yeah. Since we out here fucking on the first date, we should have some protection. Alright, you guys. So, with that, we have the do's, and I'm going to hit y'all with the don'ts on a first date. So, my first don't is don't show up to the date late. First impressions are everything. So, I'm going to have your first impression is this nigga don't care, or, you know, she don't care or whatever, and we made these plans, and this person don't care enough to even decide to show up. I mean, in my book, if we're going on the first date, you ask me out, I would like you to be there before I get there. You know what I'm saying? Because it'll make it seem like you really prepared for this, that you really was about it, you really was excited to be there with me and, you know, come around and everything like that. So that right there would show me the initiative. And then they'll be like, oh, okay, at least he showed up on time. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But if you show up late, that shows me, okay, you don't give a fuck. You dilly-dally. You playing games with my time. And my time is precious. And I could be out with somebody else that actually want to spend time with me. So, yeah. Show up on time. Show up early. That way, your first impression will be the lasting impression. Alright, you guys, so my number two don't would be, don't be all on your phone. Don't be on your phone up here talking about, taking pictures of your food and posting it all on your Instagram or Facebook, talking about you on a date or whatever, or checking stats or whatever you doing. Text messages, unless you got kids or whatever and they home and you got to answer the phone or something like that, like from the babysitter or whatever, then I could understand that. Howsoever, other than that, leave the social media for a second. Social media not gonna go and the internet not finna blow up while you on a date for a couple of hours out the night. And plus, I just think that's hella rude. It is hella rude to be all on your phone because it means like you're not showing me no attention. You going on a date to get to know somebody. You can't get to know them if you're facing the phone. You know the people on your social media already. Well, most of them anyway. But you ask me on a date and then your head all on your phone, my nigga, then don't ask me out no more because, I'm not going to fuck with you because I feel like you're not paying me no attention. And, that's not what's up. And like I told you, it's rude as hell to be on your phone while you on a date. Because we're supposed to be talking. We're supposed to be kicking it, getting to know each other. We can't get to know each other in our phones. All right, so that leads me to number three. Number three is, don't take me nowhere you have taken another bitch. And that one right there is really self-explanatory. But it also goes right along with find out what your date is interested in and build that date around that from Stacie's do's list. And it's pretty much very simple. You know, be different. Take me somewhere different. Let's go to Sips, you know what I'm saying, paint and sip. Or let's go paintballing. Let's go on a video game date. Let's go to the drive-in, whatever. But take me somewhere that is hella different from everybody else. I don't want to go on no date and we in a restaurant and the hostess, she all like, oh, hey, Brian, we just seen you the other day. You want your regular table? And then the doggone, you know what I'm saying, the waitress or the waiter come up and be like, oh, so you want your regular drinks or whatever, and then you up here bringing me food that you done bought for another bitch, and oh, you want your favorite? Nah. First of all, they give me the wrong impression of you, and that means you out there just swinging and dating and all that, which is cool, but take me somewhere else. I don't want to be seen as the other bitch, and I'm going to be different. I'm not basic, so don't do basic with me. So, yeah, don't take me nowhere, because I'm not with all that. I'm not every bitch, so don't take me nowhere where you done had other bitches. They might be basic, but do something different for me, because I'm not basic. So, moving right on along. The next one is, now Stacie, shut up, because I know you said get condoms, and since we're talking about fucking on the first date, and a lot of us are like fucking on the first date, my thing is, my fourth one is don't expect to be fucking on the first date. Now, I know, we always sitting up here talking about something, yeah, we fucking on the first date, that it is what it is. Yeah, if we have chemistry, yo, it's all good for us to fuck on the first date. If there's chemistry there and I'm digging you, and you mad dope, and everything like that, oh, most def, if it happens, the sparks fly, most def, it's bound to happen. But I feel like grown people can make that decision. You know what I'm saying? Grown people can make the decision to have consensual sex with each other without it being a big deal. But what I mean by don't expect to be fucking on the first date, don't call me, ask me out, make all these plans. We go out, we go to a nice restaurant, we kicking it and everything like that. And then at the end of the night, you expect for me to be like, oh, you want to come upstairs? Or, oh, yeah, this is what it is. Don't take me out with your end game being let's fuck. I want you to take me out with the end game being, yo, I'm trying to get to know her. But if you know, like, you're, oh, yeah, I'm going to hit her up, I'm going to take her out, yeah, I'm about to go ahead and pay for this little dinner or whatever, shit, but she better be giving up the pussy. No, sir. I ain't got to give up nothing. So don't expect me to. Now, if it happens, it happens, and that's a good thing, because that means we sparked off. But don't come on a date taking me out to dinner and being like, oh, just because you paid for a little dinner, you expecting me to drop my drawers. Nah, don't expect that. But if y'all fucking on the first day, you know I'm not judging. That's Stacie that be judging. Nah, I'm joking. But, all right, and that leads me into my last one, and my last and final don't, which is not really my last and final, but for my fifth don't on a first date would be, don't show up dressed ratchet or your pants hanging off your ass. That goes right into, you know, what Stacie said about, you know, letting your date know the dress code so they could dress appropriately, and seeing how her folk had her in the church with her freakum dress on, you know, you want to be aware of what the date is like. But if you go on a date and you ask a person out on a date or whatever the case may be, please put a belt on your ass. The most unattractive thing for a woman, I ain't talking about no girl, I ain't talking about no thoughts, you know, even though shout out to the thoughts, because they might, you know, they faithful, but they thought a little. but put a belt on, you know what I'm saying? Don't have your pants hanging off your ass. You know, don't have your ass cheeks hanging out, and, you know, don't have your titties just, I would say, don't just rack it, like, don't have on a see-through jumper with nipple pasties, and don't show up with jeans on that's coming all the way down, and you got your, you know, your drawers hanging out. That's just not appropriate. It's not attractive. And for grown-ups, not children, grown-ups, nobody's trying to see all that. That's not cute. So, yeah, don't show up dressed all ratchet and your pants hanging off your ass. It's the most unattractive thing you could ever do. That's just my opinion on it. But I know as a woman, I don't want to see a man. It turns me on to see a man that's dressed up. You know what I'm saying? If he looking good, smelling good. It's attractive, and it definitely works for me. So, yeah, that's pretty much it for my don't list. So, I'm going to shoot it right back over here to Stacie so she can give y'all the first day boiling on a budget list. All right, Stacie, go ahead and hook us up, because I think I'm going to use some of these too.
All right, you guys, we are going to jump headfirst into the balling on a budget segment, first date edition, of course. Here are my budget-friendly first date suggestions. You can take your date on a coffee and ice cream date. You can take them on a picnic in a park.
I always love me
couples game night. You can even find a paint and sip on Groupon. And if you are oh so tired of Netflix and chill like I am, you can take your date to the Starlight Drive-In. The Starlight Drive-In is located at 2000 Moreland Avenue, Southeast, Atlanta, Georgia, 30316.
Girl, I like those lists. I might have to take that up on myself because I be looking for things to do and I can't never figure out things because it always seems like I go to movies and stuff. I always go to the same thing and it's like I obviously want to do something different. And, you know, I find myself being in the house sometime on the weekends and because we can't find something to do. And I hate to let Saturdays go past and we can't find nothing to do. But those are some real good ideas without having to break your pockets. So, with that being said, babies, we are coming to a close. So, yes, we have gone through a plethora of things for our first show. And we are so freaking excited that you guys joined us on our first show. You know, ride with us, ride this wave with us. And we are definitely happy that you came. You know, we went through telling you guys about our first date experiences. And I know I ain't have not much of a first date experience. You know, and Stacie was dating and whatever. Her first date experience was kind of cute or whatever. And then we already know about sex on the first date. We clearly know how y'all like to do. And me personally, I raised my hand to yes, sex on the first date. We got a lot of good social media feedback about sex on the first date. And of course, we know how nasty y'all are. And if y'all tuning in, we know why. And we went through first dates, do's and don'ts. Remember, y'all, don't dress ratchet. And make sure you know what the appropriate dress is so you don't be in the church pew with your freakum dress on. And also, we went through first date boiling on a budget. So, you know, if you can't find things and you don't know what to do, then, you know, you hit up Groupon. Hey, Groupon, had to shout out back. And just make it happen. So, that's pretty much it for this one. And thank you, baby, so much for tuning in to our very first show. So, thank you for listening to our Petty by Nature podcast. We do hope that you enjoy this petty talk. Join us next week as we play Never Have I Ever. So get excited about that. We're going to be answering some questions. And then you'll find a little bit more about some stuff with us and some of our other social media people. And please, we just always want to let you guys know at the end of every show. Please remember, we don't want you guys to be offended at all by none of the shit that we say. Because you know how we do. So, also, just another reminder before we click out, make sure you hit us up and follow us, share us, and everything on our social media. Our Facebook and our Snapchat are PBN Podcast. And again, that is PBN Podcast on Facebook and Snapchat. Also, on our IG and Twitter, you can find us at Petty by Nature 2, which is the number 2. Again, on our IG and Twitter, you can hit us up at Petty by Nature, the number 2. And don't forget to find us and like us on iTunes and leave a review. Okay, babies, we thank you so much for being with us with our first show. Don't forget that we will definitely be rocking. So if you come on and join this ride, we're going to get better with time. All right, you guys. Bye, babes.